Srebrenica. In a war known for its brutality and civilian suffering, what happened in the Eastern Bosnian enclave in July 1995 stands out for its savagery. As the Bosnian conflict neared its end after more than 3 years of bloodshed, the Muslim-majority town of Srebrenica fell to the Bosnian Serb army.
Anniversary, but we ain't here to celebrate. 20 years later and my people still feel betrayed. Can anybody hear the cry from the grave and the cry from the mother whose son couldn't escape? But he could have been saved inside of the safe haven if it wasn't for the UN leaving the gates vacant. Let the whole town get taken, men and women separated. Over 8,000 killed, blood spilled on the pavement, buried inside a field to conceal the war crime. In the heart of Europe, one of the biggest of all time, it was raining blood on the town. It's a paramilitary killers with their fingers on the trigger. How can we consider forgiving? It's too impossible when most of the perpetrators ain't been held responsible. They got the general, but what about his minions? The ones who carried out the mass murder of civilians. Can anybody hear the cry from the grave? 20 years later, we honor the ones that passed away. 11-7-95 to the present day, we're keeping your name alive and won't forget your pain. Can anybody hear the cry from the grave? 20 years later, we honor the ones that passed away. 11-7-95 to the present day, we're keeping your name alive and won't forget your pain. Tell me, how can we forgive and how can we forget? How can we live in peace with so many people dead? I got nothing against those that never engaged in bringing devastation upon a whole nation. The memories are vivid, every year we will live it. You can hear a cry from the grave coming from every village, and only when they admit it, acknowledge what was committed, and all the soldiers that did it get rounded up and convicted, we can move on and begin to mend our broken hearts. And I pray to God that another war never starts. Our land is full of graveyards, a Balkan cemetery, a legacy of blood ingrained in our identity. How many times do we have to do this to each other? How many times our people gotta live in pain and suffer? How many ancient battles do we need to replicate? Instead of burying bodies, we need to bury hate. Can anybody hear the cry from the grave? 20 years later, we honor the ones that passed away. 11-7-95 to the present day, we're keeping your name alive and won't forget your pain. Can anybody hear the cry from the grave? 20 years later, we honor the ones that passed away. 11-7-95 to the present day, we're keeping your name alive and won't forget your pain.
In the days that followed, more than 8,000 Bosnian Muslim men and boys were systematically killed and buried in hidden mass graves. As this was going on, tens of thousands of women and young children were expelled from the area. It remains the worst atrocity in Europe since the Holocaust.
Can anybody hear the cry from the grave? 20 years later, we honor the ones that passed away. 11-7-95 to the present day, we're keeping your name alive and won't forget your pain. Can anybody hear the cry from the grave? 20 years later, we honor the ones that passed away. 11-7-95 to the present day, we're keeping your name alive and won't forget your pain.